Hey, I'm Jude from AppsFlyer. Welcome back to Marketing Decoded, your source for all things digital marketing. In this video, we'll talk about IDFA, what it is, how it impacts publishers and advertisers after iOS 14, the advent of SK Ad Network, and how the future looks post-IDFA. To learn more about this topic, check out the links in the description below. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe for the latest content on digital marketing. So, what is IDFA? Much like cookies, Identifier for Advertisers, or IDFA for short, is a unique and random identifier that Apple assigns to every iOS device to allow advertisers to measure their campaign's performance and user journeys. However, post-iOS 14, Apple shifted its focus to user privacy, which drastically limited the ability to use IDFA for mobile campaign measurement. Without access to IDFA, it's harder for advertisers and publishers to track conversion, identify users, and personalize messaging. To replace IDFA, Apple introduced SK Ad Network, or SKAN for short, as a way to measure iOS campaigns without revealing any user-level or device-specific data. So, what does the future hold post-IDFA? App marketers will look for solutions that measure user activity while preserving user privacy, such as cohort analysis, data cleanrooms, machine learning, predictive analytics, incrementality, and media mix modeling. And that just about covers the basics of IDFA in this edition of Marketing Decoded. But if you want to dive deeper, check out the links below. And also, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to stay up to date on all things digital marketing. That's it for now. I'll see you next time.